We're going to pop it open and see just how easy it is to put together. Instruction booklet. Well, you know, it looks like it's, yeah, I thought it was all put together there for a second. That's the hood. I guess it's in four sections. Wasn't quite sure how they had that hood in there. It's August 30th. Hopefully it'll be pretty easy to assemble. Hardest part's probably the tape. Thing of nuts and bolts. And the burner itself. Bottom. Yep. Oh, geez. That's a base. It's got a heavy, heavy weight on it. I think it probably weighs about 45 pounds. All right, so, we're going to put all the packaging away. Let's see. Got the hood bolts, the base bolts, some screws. Little wheels that go on the back of it. Goes down there. Battery, I guess, for the igniter and the chain. The weight out of the bottom, you take that main screw out, and I want you to put the wheels on. And so the four big bolts are for the wheels. So we're going to go ahead and it's really simple because it only goes one way. So we're going to go ahead and put these wheels on. Sixteenth. So you'll need a 9/16 wrench. You actually need two of them to tighten it down. Okay, you need to reinstall the bottom base plate. It's a 9/16 as well. Put this collar on and you just set it on top. You have to open it up so you can get your hand in there. And then you're going to use the one's marked JJ which is up here. And they have a, you don't need a nut, they have a threaded piece of metal there. So you will need a Phillips screwdriver to tighten them down with. So go ahead and finger tighten them around. Really easy to scratch. They didn't put much of paint on it. It's really easy to scratch the real thin paint they put on this. And I'm sure it's going to get quite a few scratches and bumps. And just tighten all those down. I wouldn't go too far. It doesn't look like much of a thread on the other in that little piece of metal. It's only about a thread and maybe a thread and a half, two threads of a piece of metal there. See how it goes in when you tighten these down? Alright, so next step. Next step is to attach this top piece. It just barely fits in that tube. They just specially made that, and it, you have to bend the hose, and it just barely fits in it too. So let's go ahead and put this on and what nuts do we use, what bolts do we use? These right here. It's already got the taps. They already, it's another piece of metal. It's not a tap welded. It's a piece of metal that's been threaded. So hey, you know something? There's another thing you gotta remember is before you put that other piece on, it has this kind of a tray that goes down on it. Let's see what it says about the tray. Now the tray has this little piece here. Isn't that interesting? So I guess you can move that tray up or down. That's kind of interesting. Not sure what the tray. Actually does. What do they call that tray? So it's a table. They call it a table. So that's a table. They're metric. They're not 3/8 and they're not 7/16. That's a 3/8, so I didn't bring any metric tools, so we'll just use an adjustable wrench. But they're probably a 9 or a 10. They may be an 8. It's definitely a metric. These little ones are metric, so you're not going super, super tight with it. I'd go until it, because you don't want it to come off. I wouldn't go too super tight, because I'm telling you that it ain't much of a metal that's going to be, I'm surprised there's not any lock washers. That's a pain in the butt. I should go out to the truck and get my metric socket set. But there's so few parts to this thing. Alright. So there's that top piece. Next step is to put the table on there. But we're going to have to attach this bottom piece to this. Let's see what else. I think this slides down. It's a little piece of plastic. And it doesn't show, well, yeah, it shows the P plastic ring. So you just drop that over top of your bolts there. That's real thin plastic, too. You'll have to take this little screw that was in here out. Set that over there. And then now we need to put the bolts in the, so they're EE. It's these little tiny screws here. And I hate to say it, but we are missing, unless they fail, there's one. We are missing one. I don't see it. Now, I got plenty of little screws, so there's not much holding this on either. I'm telling you, you can't be too rough with this thing. I mean, look at these little screws going to hold this table. You can't be setting four beers or anything on it. Not that I want to set, look, that don't even screw in. That just keeps turning. I don't see another one. That's all that's left there. I'm gonna go in. It could have dropped. I'm gonna go in and get another screw. I got plenty of those old black screws. There ain't much holding that. That's your, says it's a table. I still don't know what that little screw's for there. It hasn't said. Okay. Nope, that's not what that's for. It doesn't tell what that little screw, what this little screw, right here is for. So we'll wait till it's all done before we put that back in. Not real sure on that. Okay, so now it's time to put the burner on. since we know it'll fit. It's tight, but it's going. That's a tall puppy, ain't it? Put the top on, I'm gonna have to definitely stand on that chair. Alright, let's see what screws go in that. It says DD. So it's these three. So three of these things hold that on. And again, it's just really, really thin metal. I actually think this is a little thicker. This metal that they got these threads in, it's welded on the back of this little pipe. It's a little thicker than the others. I guess they didn't want to be responsible when it fell off. You know, also, the things, depending on the weight of the cylinder, we're going to use that one there. We got about five of those. The thing is, depending on the weight of the cylinder in there to keep it steady. Of course, we have the cylinder shut off right now. That's something. This was put together with rivets, this top piece. This little piece here was all put together. You saw me when I put it out. It's got rivets in it. And you know, if you move this thing around a lot, there's only four rivets holding that. I have a feeling over the next couple years, ain't much to that. Those rivets will end up probably, oh yeah, they're barely riveted in there. Ain't that something? So you got six of these screws down the bottom holding this base on, tank shroud onto the base. And you got four rivets holding this whole top piece onto that really, really thin base. You see that, how thin it is? So I can see me probably drilling and putting four screws with nuts on it. You know what I think I'm probably going to do? Is I'm probably going to go ahead and drill it and put a bolt and a nut through all the way around. Let's hope those little, they're just barely tapped. It's got three little tack welds on that L bracket there with that thread in it. I can see that also coming loose and maybe having to put an L bracket on the inside of this thing, a regular L bracket. But if that does happen, if these do break loose, you just get a standard L bracket, put two little bolts through here, drill holes, put two bolts, take the bottom base off, put two bolts in the bottom if those ever break. I can see that it's not as sturdy as the like we saw at a couple of the other stores. The $300 and $400 one is a little bit sturdier. Alright, so let's go ahead and put that top piece on. That's kind of simple. We'll put this shroud together. Have to do that first. That's that nut that I took off. And you know, we're going to have to find out where to put that battery for this igniter. Oh, it's like the grill. And you know, this grill here had the same thing. And you can see it actually rusted inside and the igniter no longer works. That's the same exact, look at that, almost the exact same type of igniter, battery for the igniter, except this extends a little farther out and it's this way, so I guess it's less likely to get water in it, as that one is facing straight up with no reins. If anything gets on here, condensation gets in there, it goes right on top of that. Okay, and then over here on the hood you have this top piece right here. Now that those three holes are for the top of that hood, but these get secured in here. Now they overlap, so the way you have to do it, and it shows on the picture here that this little groove's on top, it's not underneath. So what you have to do is first you put this bottom screw in, and you have to put the washer on the bottom side, and I'm surprised they don't put little lock washers either. And so what you need to do is you need to go all the way around it and put this outer. And I don't know why they had to screw them together. You know, someone actually had to sit there in China. It's made in China. And put these little washers and then screw the nuts on there. You know they had to do it. Alright. So, now all those other holes, they overlap with that hood there. You'll have to make sure you do the bottom one first. You know, that's so annoying to have to unscrew these. I know you probably think it's not, but when you have to do it, you'll say, why didn't they just have them separate? Just because they didn't want you to lose them. But there's a couple of them there. They give you extra. Oh no, those are the three for that top piece. Because the bolts are made into that. So that's the three for that. It's a wonder they didn't put them on that top piece. Okay, so there's the outer ring, and you'll have to tighten them down, and again, it's probably metric, because I don't think it's a 5/16, I think it's probably metric, probably a 4 or so, and then this ring here gets put on, so here we go, unscrewing all these screws. Now it goes through both of them. And into there. And it doesn't give you much room to get the tap on. It doesn't give you much room at all. In fact, it's going to be really difficult to get that tap on there. Let's see if it doesn't go on top. Let's see if that doesn't go on top. Probably gonna be better to try to put that on top. Still gonna be difficult. Yeah, it's gonna have to go on top to keep the water out. And my screw here. They don't give you any bigger screws for the top. It's the same. But it works a little bit better. So you'll have to flip that over. Once I get the four in on the seams, we'll put the others in between. And again, you have to unscrew them. Don't forget to tighten them. I can see the wind catching this thing and flipping it right over. As we get some wind up here in the mountains. That one barely lines up. What I'll probably do is use a pair of pliers and a screwdriver to hold that, pliers to hold the nut and a screwdriver to tighten the screw. Rather than trying to use a wrench. Okay, so there's the seams. There's the seams, and you still got, they want you to put one in between as well. So we're going to go ahead and put that in, and then I'm going to go grab a pair of pliers and we'll tighten these up. So I'm just going to put a pair of pliers on it and tighten them up. So I got about 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. We have 12 of these to do. So I'm going to go ahead and tighten these up, and then I'll show you putting the hood on the unit, and then we'll fire this puppy up and see what it does. So I'm just going to stand on this little chair. Watch me bust my ass. See if we get this lined up without having to get the ladder out. Right. I done dropped one of those little washers too. Let me put these in my pocket. I think I'm going to have to get the ladder out. Because you know what? I see the problem. It goes the opposite direction. See that? Now it should go right on. That's a valuable lesson there. That goes the opposite direction. Now I'm going to have to go find a little washer. Washer goes on. Whoops. Washer goes on there. Let's get these two on, I'll go in and grab another little washer. And my camera installation box for putting in cameras and stuff, I have plenty of those little washers. We got a little thing of washers if you happen to drop one. Stand up on this chair. That's a lock washer, that's why that ain't gonna work. You get a flat one. Alright, I'm going to get this little pair of pliers and tighten those. Actually, I'll just use this little crescent wrench. Because I know they're not 3/8. Too far on them just so that it's snug. You know, I looked at one at Lowe's that was $403.99. It's fully assembled. It's a little better quality, I think. I didn't look at it that close. Alright, so, not sure what the chain's for. Let's see what it says about this chain. What do we suppose the chain's for? Oh, the chain goes. That's just funny. The chain goes across here. In these little grooves, so when you're moving it, your canister don't fall out. Yep, so the positive post, it doesn't tell you, goes out. Let me look in the book here and see if it tells you again. I don't see it discussing the igniter at all. Just says, oh, here it is, look. You see that? It says battery. It's got a little tiny diagram with the positive out. That's on way back when you first put the unit on there. Alright. Let's take this thing away from... Oh well, that's not gonna, that really sucks, those wheels really, really suck. Yeah, that's really gonna do well. Alright, turn on the gas. Boy, that ignited real quick. Alright, she's throwing out the heat. I don't know if you can see that. Only I can figure. She keeps you from raising that table up any higher. There she be. The main stays patio heater, 40,000 BTU. Says electronic ignition. Of course, you know it's got the little igniter on it. Anti-tilt safety device. So if it goes to tilt, it's supposed to shut off. I'm going to tell you right now, the only problem I see with this unit is the fact that this whole piece, which is probably 30 pounds, is attached with four little rivets. So you see how that's doing? I'm going to tell you one thing. What I'm going to do is I'm going to drill holes. See if I got any with little taps on them. And my other box in there. I'm going to drill four holes between these rivets. And I am going to put a bolt with a nut with a lock washer, with a washer all through, with another washer and a lock washer and a nut on it to secure that top down. Because I have a feeling, especially when the wind gets up around here, if we leave this outside, I have a feeling that that top piece, those rivets could pop real easy. It's just a feeling. Assembly and startup. You have to buy your tank separate. Other than that, there she be. So for Tom's Farm and Garden Channel, I'm talking Tom Moore. Good luck to you. What it looks like in the dark, I mean, it puts out the flame. Look at that. Anyway, she gets pretty warm.